digging into keto stuff, you're gonna hear the bulletproof coffee and MCT oil 100,000 times. So bulletproof coffee is basically you brew coffee however you like it, and then if you like black coffee, then it can be black coffee, and you can either add butter, preferably grass-fed organic butter. So the butter that I use in Dubai is actually Kerrygold. It's an Irish brand. You can buy salted or unsalted, and it's grass-fed, meaning that the cows were fed grass, duh, as opposed to corn or soybeans, right? So that's a healthier option for butter. You can add a teaspoon of ghee, say like bison ghee. I usually buy at Trader Joe's in the States, bison ghee. So it's like it's also called the clarified butter. Okay, you can read somewhere about it, and then if you subscribe, you're gonna end up watching one of those episodes about the ghee that I'm gonna make in the future. Or you can add, which I usually do, MCT oil, because it's transparent. It has no really flavor. It has like no taste, no color, nothing. So I usually add, MCT to my coffee, and then I put it all in a blender with, say, unsweetened coconut or unsweetened almond milk. It's very important. I'm emphasizing the fact that it's got to be unsweetened, because like I mentioned before, just the fact that you switch from cow's milk to coconut or almond doesn't guarantee you that you're going to avoid consuming unnecessary sugars. Because if you start reading labels, those regular coconut and almond milks, they still have per 100 milliliters 3-4 grams of sugar. So it's the same as cow's milk. It just doesn't, you know, have lactose, but still it's like sugary. So make sure it says on the label unsweetened coconut or unsweetened almond milk, and then you add it all together in a blender. And once you blend it, what happens, the magic of MCT is basically that you get a really beautiful froth on top. So it's like a cappuccino or a latte, and it's like as if you steamed your milk. Okay, so it's nice, yummy. It has a very rich texture. It's nice and thick, okay? And then you can just pour it in a takeaway cup, takeaway mug, and just, you know, have it in your car or have it at work or on your way to work if you don't feel like preparing anything or eating, you know? And MCT oil, it's a, you're gonna hear it over and over again, because MCT is my thing. Like, you know, when they ask you one thing that you would take to uninhabited island, MCT, you got it right. So I would definitely take MCT with me. I'm not sure how much it would help me in, surviving months and months, but like definitely I would be better off with than, you know, without it. So you're gonna have that. Sometimes what I do, I have MCT, like bulletproof coffee, say like 2-3 p.m. If I'm headed to play tennis for like, you know, 2 hours in the afternoon, or I'm going for a workout session because for whatever reason I didn't do it in the morning on my fasted state, but I'm doing it in the afternoon, then I usually have that before my big workout, because again, it's fuel, it's pure fuel. I'll do another episode about MCT and about benefits, because the list is ongoing, and a lot of Alzheimer's and Parkinson's patients are being given MCT oil. Definitely helps to get rid of the what we call a brain fog, that sometimes you're like trying to remember, you're gonna enter your living room, it'll be like, why am I here again? What, I was gonna get something from here, but what was it? So your brain loves fat. Your brain runs on fat, mind you, healthy fat, not bacon, okay? We already established that. So once you consume MCT regularly, you'll see the difference. You're gonna be so sharp, whether it's gonna be 2 p.m. or 2 a.m., you'll be able to remember your shopping list. Like, I usually do my shopping list, especially if I travel to the States, because I wanna make sure I don't forget anything. And then I end up, like, I was in DC 2 or 3 weeks ago, and I had like 25 items on my shopping list. I did not look at it once. Only before going to a checkout, I looked at it. I did not forget a single item from my 25 item shopping list, because your brain is like the latest software update app. I mean, it's just, it runs so smoothly. And yeah, of course, every now and then I'll just like forget something, but that's nothing major. But you're gonna get surprised at like, whoa,
what's happening. Like,
you're gonna see the difference, you're gonna feel the difference. So I'll do another episode on MCT because I could go on and on about it. So we established what you're having for breakfast, okay? If you don't like eggs or if you cannot eat eggs, there's and you were always you know, the oatmeal slash porridge eater, there's a beautiful idea for keto oatmeal. I'm gonna you know, put on Instagram and also on YouTube recipe for oatmeal, which is basically grinded flax seeds, chia seeds and hemp seeds, and then you can buy those mixes. I saw last week in Barcelona, I'll post a picture of the packaging. I also bought it at Sainsbury's and Tesco in the UK, so if you live there, then yeah. And I am actually on the lookout if maybe it's gonna come to Dubai soon, because since I saw it in Carrefour in Barcelona, I'm assuming that it might make its way to Carrefour shelves in Dubai. So I'll be happy to inform you guys about it if I see it there. And then I usually just sprinkle some, you know, cinnamon powder on top, and a few chopped walnuts and almond flakes, coconut flakes, raw cacao nibs. And trust me, if you tried it, you would never ever, and I mean ever, look at the regular porridge ever again. And it takes the same amount of time to prepare it, because you either like pour coconut milk over it, whether you like it cold, whether you're like hot, whether you like hot water over it, so that, you know, it absorbs and gets thick, but you don't feel like you're missing out. There's keto substitutes for everything: keto tortillas, keto empanadas, keto pastas, fries. I make keto burger buns, keto bread, keto wraps. I mean, on and on and on and on. So you won't be missing out. Trust me. Because you don't want to swallow anything for breakfast, then you have the bulletproof coffee, whether you consume in the morning or afternoon when you feel like you need a boost for the rest of the day. That should take you for a few hours. And then in the next episodes, I'm going to cover lunch ideas, dinner ideas, if you feel like eating three times a day. I started off by eating three times a day, and then I just made my way naturally to eating two meals a day. So I usually eat breakfast when I break my fast, 11, 12 p.m. And then I will have, say, like spinach, a smoothie around 2, 3 p.m. or bulletproof coffee if I'm going for, like, you know, 2 hours sweating tennis session. And then I'll have my dinner 6, 7 p.m. the latest. This is like on the regular days, because obviously there are those days when I'm traveling and I don't really have a night. I'm flying day and then night, and then I get somewhere and it's another day it's starting. So my day is like, you know, 36 hours long, because I'm one of those people that don't nap. So I don't sleep on the planes, I don't sleep on the trains, I don't sleep in the car. I just don't nap. Like, I can sleep, but I don't nap. And the thing is, a lot of people who got keto adapted, they said that they lost, or maybe that they lost ability to nap, or they actually gained ability to stay awake without having to nap. I know it's all about the 15-minute power naps, go ahead, but you'll notice, or you might notice, or some of you will, is that you don't need this anymore. You don't need, because you don't go into, you know, like energy debt. You basically, your energy is stable, and you don't have those, you know, periods when you're lethargic and you're like, oh my gosh, I want to close my eyes. It's just like, what can I do next, you know? So this is the beautiful feeling. Give it a try with MCT Bulletproof Coffee. See how well that's going to fill you up and for how many hours, okay? If you feel like you need to go ahead and have lunch or another meal or snack or something, then have another Bulletproof Coffee. Don't start with crazy amounts of MCT though at first. Start with consuming altogether 1 tablespoon a day, like 15, 20 milliliters, but divide it into 2 separate sittings. So say have half of it, 1 teaspoon, say in the morning or when you're like starting your day or breaking your fast if you're already doing intermittent fasting, and then have another coffee or sprinkle it on top of your salad later. Because you know what, if you're just starting with, you know, consuming fats and especially consuming MCT oil, it might be a bit rough on your stomach. So I don't want you to get indigestion, I don't want you to be in pain, and most importantly, I don't want you to spend your days in a toilet. Go figure why. So please, just like little portions, don't go from one extreme to another extreme or from this extreme to this extreme, because you're gonna suffer, okay? You'll be basically saying hello to your toilet every 5 minutes. Stay reasonable, please. You have to get your microbiome, which is the bacterial flora in your gut. You have to get it used to the new eating style, okay? So again, this is one of the symptoms for people who go through the keto flu. Those are the frustrating side effects. You know, when you're changing from the glucose burner to fat burner, but it's worth it and it's not gonna last forever. But just make sure you get your electrolytes right. And for that reason, subscribe, because this way you're gonna stay up to date with all the little nuts and bolts how to do keto properly. But just one thing for sure, you guys, you are gonna stay hyper till next time. Promise me that. Bye.